Talk about that transition now. What are you doing civilian occupation wise? What opportunities are you pursuing? What can you pass on to others that are following in your footsteps?
So civilian occupation, me and my dad and one other fellow, we went and started up an environmental services business. We're getting it up and running right now, jumping through the hoops of the federal and state governments. But again, there's great resources out there for potential entrepreneurs in the community. And I would highly encourage every ranger that's coming out looking at entrepreneurship right off the bat, because you know, rangers are successful at whatever they put their minds to. If that's running a business, you're going to be the best damn business runner there is.
Yeah, you know, there's a misperception out there that rangers are people that you point at a target and you say go, and they have to follow all the orders along the way to get there. When the reality is that as situations change, you're making decisions on the fly and you're adjusting to it in order to achieve success. And when you go into civilian occupation, going to work for somebody where you got to be there every morning at 8 o'clock and you leave at 5, or you know, if you stay extra late, 6 or 7, and you're sitting in a cubicle and people are shoveling crap at you all day long. I mean, that would be to me an impossible existence. But when you look at going out, identifying, starting a business, now you're looking at, you can list out the problems or the challenges that are in front of you. You start putting together your plan and your resources and you start knocking them down, and pretty soon, holy cow, you have a business that you started. And I think that veterans, especially Ranger veterans, are ideally suited to be small business people, own their own business.
I totally concur. And, you know, there are so many great organizations as well as parks that come along with being a veteran-owned small business. You know, if you are thinking about it, I tell you one thing that's been extremely helpful for me is the PTAC, and that was recommended by Carl. By you, the PTAC down here in the Sacramento district where I live has been phenomenal. I couldn't tell you what the PTAC stands for off the top of my head.
PTAC stands for Procurement Technical Assistance Center.
There we go. Okay.
Yeah, and their whole job is to teach veterans how to do business with the federal government. Actually, their job is to teach anybody how to do business with the federal government, but they have knowledge about how to help veterans achieve that.
So yeah, that is a huge part of it. And the other thing that this lady has been extremely helpful at the PTAC with helping me out is she's literally gone through and explained step by step the things that need to happen when it comes to the registration and verification processes for service disabled vet owned and operated small business. Invaluable resource. You get a person directly assigned to you. So if you are thinking about going down that road, remember PTAC. You're going to have 8 million different acronyms and things to remember. But once you get into the business, remember PTAC, and then also Carl.
And the PTAC doesn't, there's no expense for the PTAC. You don't have to pay any money.
No expense. Yeah. No expense.
Good.
No expense. So yeah.
We got a couple more minutes. What other kind of lessons learned would you like to pass on, or anything else you'd like to add?
I can't hit on mindset enough. I think this transition process for me, I'm still young in the transition. I got out in November 30th is my last day. I started terminal leave late September. So I'm still early on in the transition process, but I'll tell you, your mentality is everything. I can't stress that enough. Your mentality is everything. I ignorantly started trying to, think I could do it alone, and you're not going to be able to do it alone. You didn't get to Ranger School alone. You don't do much in the Army alone. You're not going to transition alone. Okay. So reach out, ask questions and get help. Okay. But also remember that nobody owes you anything. You got to get out and get it. Okay. Yeah.
That's a great point. Yeah. I've heard veterans say, oh, because I serve the community or the country owes me something. The only thing they owe you is if you got hurt, they owe you the care to either compensate you for it or make that somehow fixed. But other than that, you don't get a special car, a special job or anything else just because you served in the military. You work darn hard to become a ranger. You have to work darn hard to be successful as a business owner or an employee at another business too.
Absolutely.
All right. That's the official part.